My name's Meg Jones. I'm a reporter from the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel. I'm at Burge Hall at the UW-Madison campus today, and I just interviewed a botany professor here at UW named Ken Cameron, who happens to be the world's foremost vanilla orchid expert. And I found out about the story kind of through a different way. I was working on a story about John Muir this summer, and I found out that Wisconsin has home to like 3 dozen native orchids, which I didn't know. And so I was doing a story about an orchid restoration project that I found out about at the Muir story. And while I was there, they said, oh, you know, by the way, did you know that the lead guy in vanilla is a UW-Madison professor? And I thought, if I thought that was interesting, maybe other people might as well, too. So just I came here and interviewed Ken Cameron, who told me all kinds of very, very interesting things about the vanilla orchid, which happens to be the only, like, agriculture product from the orchids, and there's hundreds of thousands of orchid species. About 100 of those are vanilla orchids, though. And here's some interesting things that I found out about vanilla. It's native to Mexico, and when the Spanish explorers went to Mexico centuries ago, they took the vanilla beans and the vanilla plants back to Europe. They didn't really take too much interest in vanilla, but the French did. And so then the French took the plants to French holdings like Tahiti and Madagascar and Reunion. And now Madagascar happens to be the number one vanilla export country in the entire world, which is fascinating. And Ken Cameron is doing here is he's doing lots of really interesting research on vanilla orchids and their DNA. And he found out that the vanilla orchids that are in Tahiti are actually a hybrid that came from, and he was able to figure this out through DNA. And one other interesting thing he's doing is he's working on a vanilla orchid barcode database so that you don't need to see the flower of the orchid to determine flower of the vanilla orchid to determine what kind of vanilla plant it is, but you'll be able to use this barcode. So, very interesting. I guess I'll be thinking about this when I'm doing my holiday baking and pulling out my bottle of vanilla. So you can read the story on jsonline.com and see photos taken by Andy Manis along with this video.